I'm floating away. No, toast. That's dumb. Anyway, where to start? All right, no practice. All right.
Just do it. Just do
I'll just do a daily toast.
Just do a daily toast.
Okay. Greetings, citizens. Here I am. I'm floating in outer space. Or am I on the slopes of a ski resort? Or maybe I'm in Japan. I don't know. Anyway, toast. Welcome to our daily toast. I guess this is a Monday that we're doing this one. And happy Monday, I guess. Nobody likes Mondays, especially not Garfield. Anyway, hey, let's do a daily toast. Today we're going to be toasting this game. This is not quite a compilation. Maybe it is a compilation. Super Mario All-Stars, right? So this is the game that does the Super Nintendo versions of Mario 1, Mario 2, Mario 3, and Mario Lost Levels, which is, you know, it's the Japanese version of Mario 2, which was too hard for Americans, says Nintendo of Japan. And so instead, they put Mario characters into Doki Doki Panic and called that Mario 2. Anyway, so we got all four games on here. What is good about this compilation? Well, for one thing, it canonizes the Mario universe. Because originally, in the NES version, Mario 1, it was like this whole world of Mario 1. Then Mario 2 felt like it was a whole different world. And Mario 3 looked completely different. And then there's Mario World, which was the fourth one. And that looks completely different also, right? But what this one did is it had like the same kind of graphic style for Mario in each game and the same graphic style for like the backgrounds and all the enemies in each game. It all matched Mario World. So this is the game that kind of defined what the Mario World is, and this is how it is supposed to look. So that's pretty cool. But you know what I don't like about this game? In the NES games, you jump on a Goomba, it makes that bloop sound, you know, that bloop. And this game, you jump on a Goomba, it's like clink. It's like, wait a minute, wait, what was that I just heard? You jump on another Goomba, clink. It's like, that's not the sound a Goomba makes. I had the hardest time accepting Super Mario All-Stars. But overall, if you can just get over the Goomba sound, it's a pretty good game. It even established Mario's fire powers, because in Mario 1, you know, he gets the fire flower. He got the white overalls with the red shirt, but then in Mario 3 he gets the firepower and he turns completely orange. So in this one they kind of fix that up to where he turns, you know, the original white and red. And also they made Luigi match Mario World where he turns white and green. So that's nice too, right? Toast. All right, what else can we say about Super Mario All-Stars? Nothing. We're good. Thanks for watching Daily Toast. Tune in tomorrow for another one.